Team Gross, and this is my movie review on The Conjuring. So I'm here at the AMC Theater at the Newport on the Levee, and man, this place is hopping with people, okay? This is a great movie weekend, you know, for some great opening films. But right now, I'm here to talk about The Conjuring. Now, this movie stars Patrick Wilson, Vera Farmiga, Ron Livingston, and Lily Taylor. And this movie here, dude, I gotta tell you, and dudettes, this movie was scary. Wow. Getting ahead of myself here. Let me back up just a little bit. This movie is based on a true story, where you have a family that moves into a new farm home, or a new farm. And, you know, they're, you know, an average American family back in the 70s. Dad's a truck driver, mom's a stay-at-home mom, kids go to school. And they move into this house, and, well, the youngest child starts seeing things. She's seeing spirits in the house. Before you know it, the spirits are making themselves known to the family. They're visiting them in their sleep. You know, people are waking up with, you know, marks and bruises. And what's up? Nobody knows, you know, what is going on. Well, mom decides, hey, I think we've got a ghost in the house. Let's go do some research. So she goes and she checks out, you know, these folks that are into demonology and paranormal investigation. The Warrens. And this couple, you know, have gone on tour, you know, to different colleges, and they've, you know, spoken and told people, you know, what's going on in the supernatural realm, and, you know, things that they have had to do and their experiences. When the mom comes and says, hey, listen, I've got this thing that's happening in my life, you know, can you please come and check my house out? Tell me what's going on. What can I do to protect my home? And the bad thing about what I'm telling you is this is true. It's based on a true story. Yeah, okay. Here's some trailer footage, and I'll come back with my final thought.
Based on a true story. In 1971, the Perrin family moved into their dream home.
It's gonna be great.
But they didn't know it was the site of a brutal murder in 1863. And countless horrors in the century that followed. What happened to the parents in that house was so disturbing, the family has refused to speak of it. Until now.
First day, we fell in love with the house.
I get my own room.
The owner says, do you and your family a favor, Roger. He says, keep the lights on in this house at night. A couple of days later, it came back to me, and I had an idea that something was wrong.
From day one, there was a heaviness and there was a scariness.
Things began to happen in the house.
We started to see multiple spirits in the house.
See? It's standing right behind you.
Because I was the youngest and the most vulnerable, I was approached more than anyone, and I actually had a relationship with that boy.
I think something bad happened to him.
Follow me this way.
I had gone to bed. I opened my eyes. The apparition started to come down to me.
Look what she made me do.
Nancy?
From the director of Saw and Insidious.
We waited 30 years to tell our story. Because 30 years ago, the world was not prepared for this.
On July 19th.
Oh, God!
Experience the terrifying truth.
So this movie movie's rated R. It's 1 hour and 52 minutes in length, and it's directed by James Wan. Wow. What do you say about The Conjuring? Dude, this movie was freaking scary, okay? It takes a lot to scare me, okay? I've seen all kinds of horror movies, you know, I've watched Saw, I've watched Insidious, which, you know, this director has, you know, had some dealings with. I've seen, you know, Paranormal Activity, I've seen, you know, Poltergeist, you know, you name it, scary film. I've probably watched it, if not have it at home, in my own personal library. This movie is freaky, okay? It's scary. I sat in the theater watching this movie, and there were people behind me that were, you know, some were praying because there were things that were happening on the screen, and they're, oh, sweet Jesus. And other people were screaming at the top of their lungs because they were frightened at the sound effects and the images that were being portrayed on the screen, okay? Wow. Guys, you did one heck of a job putting this movie together, okay? Now, I know your source material, you know, was you know, all stuff that was, you know, based on fact, and, you know, you guys had real accounts from, you know, the family and from the Warrens, and all I can say is, wow. You know, I'm glad that this didn't happen to me. I'm glad it hasn't happened to anybody that I know. This movie was definitely one for the books if you are a history buff of any kind and if you are a horror film buff of any kind. It's not shot like a documentary. I mean, this is almost like you're living it with the family. The visual effects in this film were off the wall. I mean, the demons and ghosts and entities that you see in this film are very freaky looking, you know, but, you know, it's not something that's so far-fetched that you cannot imagine that it's not real, you know? I mean, this stuff was really, really freaky, okay? Wow. I've said all that to say this. If you're easily scared, make sure you take someone with you so they can hold your hand, okay? Guys, this is definitely one that's gonna have your girlfriend jumping out of her seat into your lap. Girls, if your guy's got a soft stomach, don't take him to see this movie because you'll be the one driving home at the end of the night, okay? Wow. James Wan, my hat's off to you. You know, the whole cast and crew that put this movie together, you guys did one heck of a job, okay? Definitely. The Conjuring, in my opinion, dude, this movie gets an A+. You know, the movie was just, wow. That's really all I can say is, wow. Will I see it again? Yeah, I'm going to wind up seeing this again because I promised someone I would take it or take them to the film. Will I buy the DVD or Blu-ray? Probably. And because I'm an idiot and I like to be scared every once in a while, and this actually scared me, I'll probably watch it a couple times over the years. You know, this was an amazing film. So if you're looking for something scary this weekend to watch, no, it's not Halloween, I understand that, but hey, it's always a good time to watch a horror flick, right? Check out The Conjuring. Conjuring opens July 19th, this weekend, playing in theaters nationwide. For the Rag Review and CNN's I Report, I'm Rajiim Gross.